समीता, राजन, पार्वती अम्मा, वेलकम राजेंद्र, शिवोहम, सगाईराज, मुत्कुलानंद एंड मास्टर अशोक छोटवानी, शिवोहम टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम टू दिस कॉल. वी हैव ब्रिजेट, गौरीश, रेखा एंड गिरीश, हु आई कैन सी. And then there are many of you whom I can't see, but I welcome you all to this call. Today there's an interesting subject, and I don't know how you would take this spiritually, but the subject that comes today is, in these times of uncertainty, I'm asking you this question. We are living in times of uncertainty. How can we live each day with joy instead of fear? Anybody would like to try?
Can I try? Shivam,
yes, please. Shivam, please try.
Daily when we are joining a meeting, we come to know so many new things. Even though we are following it, but like the last one which you said 3 to 4 days back, 8 plus 8 plus 8 formula, use it. Which you said 8 hours plus 8 hours plus 8 hours.
Connection.
That is 24. So less you sleep, more you do. Be in spiritual world, reading and doing chanting and verses, through this we can remain happy. And the first thing is meditation, which I get up and do at 4 o'clock. Even though it is 10 minutes, 20 minutes, but you told me you do it twice or thrice. Really, that shutting off all the senses really makes you out of the world and makes you very peace and comfort in spite of all these challenges day to day.
Even 2 minutes.
Yes.
Not 20 yes. minutes. If you shut off just 2 minutes, somebody may wonder, what will 2 minutes do? Just try it to shut off 1 minute.
It happens.
You shut off just 1 minute and stay still. So the challenge is, in these times of uncertainty, how? The question in front of us is how? I'm reading, how can we live each day with joy? So Sanjay Das says, the way to do it, according to Sanjay Das, I'm just expressing what he said. He said, by using our time for spiritual methods, not just sleeping through life, instead of sleeping 8 hours, 9 hours, 10 hours. Some people can sleep even 14 hours, 16 hours. If you don't wake them up, some people will keep on sleeping. But what do you get from sleeping? What is sleep? For a quick moment, before I let somebody else speak. Sleep is a process of restoration. It restores the body and the mind. That's all. It has to restore. Some people need 4 hours. I need minimum 5 hours. I need 5 hours a day. If I don't get 5 hours a day, I get disturbed. I become foggy. My mind, my body becomes foggy. But I don't need 8 hours. Some people, I thought that the 8 hours is minimum. So my dear friends, so Sanjay Das came about how even silence, chanting can create joy instead of fear. Anybody else
Shivam,
would like to try?
Shivam, pranam Guruji, may I try?
Pranam Mataji, bataiye.
Guruji, actually we are living in uncertainty. People are fearful because of especially COVID, and they fear death, which is natural. They are scared that if they will die, they will lose their property, their name, their power, their fame, and relations, and everything with which they are connected. And they live in fear. And they feel that they will bear physical pain, and mind is bombarding such thoughts, and they are in mess. But enlightened person knows that if at all he is suffering with physical pain, that is only the pain of the body. And mind is bombarding thoughts, that is also in his control.
Yes.
And he can overcome everything if he is an enlightened person. He knows that he is a divine soul and he is connected with the God. So all these things will not affect him and he will live with joy.
Very good. Shivam. Very well said. These are tough times and people are scared of so many things. People are scared of disease. People are scared of death. People are scared of the future. No, people are scared of many things, my dear friends. But what our Mataji said now, she said that a person who is enlightened, what is the matter for a person who is enlightened? The person who is enlightened says, ye to ek natak hai, kuch sach na hai, prabhu ki ye leela hai, sab maya hai. Now the person who is in the world, if you go and tell the person who is in the normal world, they will say, you're mad, you're crazy, you're singing song, you're crazy. Yeah, because in the end, everybody has to die. Everybody has to die. So how does it matter? You die today, you die after 2 months or 2 years. How does it matter? What's the big deal? What is the big deal? Because we are ignorant. What our Mataji told just now, we are ignorant. What are we ignorant about? That nobody can touch us. Nobody can touch us. If you believe in the divine, if you believe in God, nobody, no COVID, no corona, no damn it, anything can touch you. And if you even put 10 masks on your face, you can get not only COVID, you can get all kinds of diseases and you can die. Are death is certain. The realized person knows what's the big deal. Come on. What's the big deal? But the person who's ignorant will say, what are you talking? What are you talking? Come on, what are you talking? Huh? You know, I know somebody who died. You know, I know somebody who got COVID. Is it so difficult to understand that birth is not in our hands? You and me were born. We have no control. Who were our parents? Which day we were born? Which country we were born? Which religion we were born? We have no control. What's the big deal? We don't control birth. We don't control death. We control everything in between in terms of what we can do. But what happens in our life, we don't control. As you're sitting now, the ceiling can fall on your head. Can you control it? There can be a fire right around your corner. Can you control it? You can do nothing about it. There can be a tsunami. I mean, Maldives. There can be a tsunami. As I'm talking to you, you'll see waves. You'll see this whole room is full of water. Can I do anything? Why should I worry? So what did I say sometime back? I don't think I told all of you this thing. I told you last time. I told you. Why worry? There is no need to worry. Why worry? There is no need to worry. No problem, then there is no need to worry. If there's a problem, then there is no need to worry. Huh? No problem, no need to worry. If there's a problem, there is no need to worry. If you can do something about your problem, then there is no need to worry. Enjoy your curry. Why do you worry? Don't worry. If you can do something, if you can do nothing about your problem, then there is no need to worry. Why do you worry? Don't worry. No need to worry. See how this soul, the enlightened person says, there is no need to worry. If there's no problem, then don't worry. Why are people worrying today in the world? Because even though there is no problem, they worry. Oh, what about the Delta variant? Oh, ye kya ho gaya? Delta variant. Somebody came and told me, abhi Delta variant aa gaya, Delta. I said, theek hai, abhi Delta variant aega to kya problem hai? Said, somebody else came and told me, now there is new 4.2 variant. I said, kya ye 4.2 variant? They keep on creating variants. You know who creates? The news media. Because if the news media doesn't create all these variants, you'll stop watching TV. They have to shut down the TV. The news, the duty of the television is dan 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 breaking news. Taliban ne kisi ka muh khoon kar diya. If they don't tell you tragedies, you will stop watching. Have you ever seen television talking good things? Have you ever seen television talking good things? Do you know when I watched television last? I watched television before 2014. The day I got realized the truth, I stopped watching television completely. I don't watch television. So my dear friends, anybody wants to say something because we get back to question answers? Anybody wants to say anything else on this?
Sure. Ashok Chotwani, sir.
Bol Ashok.
Sir, we can live each day with joy only when we realize, self-realized, and God realized. Then come we
again.
Can live.
I missed you, Ashok. Please come again.
Yeah, we can live each day with joy.
Yeah.
Only when we self-realize and God realizes it, we can live in Satyananda and enjoy it.
How? Tell the group how.
And when we self-realize, that means we are not body, mind, and ego. We will be free from the physical pain of body, misery of mind, and agony of ego, sir. And when we see God in everyone, then we can live in joy, sir.
What you say is perfectly picked out of the textbook. People will not understand like this. So, how do you, suppose when you have a fear, how do you deal with it? Give me one example, Ashok. You're a brilliant seeker. Give me one example in the last 1 month. A fear has come to your life and how you have dealt with it. Can you please share with us?
I have realized that I am divine soul. So there is no question of fear, sir. When we are...
You have no fear divine, at all?
No, never, sir, no.
Okay. So what stops you now from God realization? Have you already realized God or something is stopping you?
Up to certain extent, I have realized, sir.
Okay, good. So Ashok says, I have no fear. That's a big achievement. Yes, Ashok has been on this call every day. See, some of you don't realize, you feel this call is like one, what they say, no, ice cream. Kabhi kabhi theek hai. Kabhi kabhi nahi chalta hai. This call is like breathing. You need oxygen. We need to be on this call on a regular basis. If I don't come on this call for 3 days, the call will lose its meaning. We need, people, I try to explain to people, you are not the body. I gave you all two. If you tell a person and they don't understand these 2 points about I am not the body, then they must be an idiot. Because the 2 points are this. At death, we leave the body and we go. That's why people burn the body. So we are not the body. At birth, we are born first as a single cell. Then the body comes around. After explaining this to everybody or some people, they say, what you say is correct. But I don't realize I am not the body. Knowledge, my friends, is not realization. This call, we must come again and again. And that's why I want to ask you all personal questions. How is this helping you? What is the problem you are facing? Some of you should come and tell, I am having this problem. Because according to me, you should live in a life of peace and bliss. Some of you are on this call for so many years, but still you are worried. Still you are disturbed. Still you are mentally unstable. Still you are not happy in life. That means something is wrong. That means your mind has not calmed. Your mind has not overcome the ignorance. The point is very clear. This is a natak. This is a leela. We are actors. We are like puppets. We come and we go. A show. What's the big deal? Why should we struggle so much? So over to you. Questions, administrator, let's do some question answer.
Kiran Kathuria,
bataye. What is your question? Kiran Kathuria.
Pranam Guruji.
Namaste, boliye.
Guruji, we always think that we are not having ego. But in reality, we try to subside it and it lies in dormant stage. But if something you have done excellent, then if somebody will appreciate it, then your ego will awaken. Why we can get rid of that also?
Yes, because when you realize you are not the ego, suppose you appreciate me today. What is my reaction? Does my ego come alive and do I say, I am so big. Is that my reaction?
यू आर एनलाइटेंड पर्सन, पर हमारी जैसे जो नॉर्मल कॉमन मैन है वो कहीं ना कहीं उसकी ना ईगो सेटिस्फाई होती है.
लेट मी एक्सप्लेन. आई एम स्टिल, आई मायसेल्फ स्ट्रगल विद द माइंड एंड ईगो मेनी टाइम्स. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज व्हेन द रियलाइजेशन कम्स, क्या मैं क्या हूँ, कुछ भी नहीं, सब कुछ तुम ही हो प्रभु, तुम बिन मैं क्या कुछ भी ना. द सिंपल रियलाइजेशन, किरण आई एम टॉकिंग नाउ इन दिस वोकल कॉर्ड हियर, इफ ओनली लिटिल स्नैप कट हैपेंस आई विल बिकम डम फॉर लाइफ. इन द ब्रेन इफ देयर इज अ स्मॉल क्लॉट, जस्ट वन डॉट, आई विल बिकम मैड in 1 second. What is ego? What are we talking about ego? We are nothing. Is it difficult to understand that we are nothing?
But at times we forget.
Nahin, that is wrong. That means you have to remember this constantly. Every day you should tell 10 times, I am nothing. You are everything. I am not alone, thou art. I do nothing, you do everything. You say this every day. Stop meeting, making chai, coffee and sandwich. Wo sab kisi aur ko bolo karne. You become perfect in the subject. Very important to real. Actually, I'm asking you what I'm saying is wrong or right. Are we anything? What are we?
Hum kya hai? But we forget for that moment.
Our biggest problem is forgetfulness. And our biggest strength is remembrance. This is the last word I had with my Guruji before I never spoke to him again. The last word my Guruji told me before, the final, only last word conversation, me and my Guruji. I asked him, Dada, tell me today, what do you think is the biggest problem? He said, forgetfulness. I told him, what is our biggest strength? He said, remembrance. That's all.
I promise I will always remember.
Yeah. We should not forget. Prabhu. You are everything. What am I? Main kuch bhi nahi. Main kya hoon? I'm nothing. Next question, please.
Then we have typed question.
Yes.
Anybody asking any live question?
Yeah.
Any live question?
Shivam
Rajendra.
As far as today's question is concerned, how can we become,
joyful? Fear to joy.
Yeah. So, just now we heard the conversation between you and Kiranji. So Haji, what I want to say that recently, what happened to me is conveyed to you all. I mean, through yourself. And I want to say that at the time of that accident, it was so terrible accident. I want to describe. Thank you. Yeah. So I was actually riding on my bike.
Yeah.
Actually, there was hurry in my mind. And I wanted to see doctor for taking the second opinion for my nephew, who was suffering from slip disc. Okay. And was already in the hospital.
Okay.
So doctors had suggested him for the surgery. So he wanted some second opinion. So I thought, okay, I'm free. I can go and have the discussion with the doctor. But I wasn't left with enough time so that I can meet the doctor. So there was hurry in my mind, but my speed of the bike was not too high.
Okay.
It was around 2:15, 2:30 in the afternoon. And I was just moving with a normal speed. I mean, it must be around 40 okay. kilometers per hour. And suddenly I could see that there is sand and metals spreaded on the road due to a construction site. And I know better, I had earlier experiences as well, that whenever our bike rides on the sand and metal, it is slippery kind of a thing. Okay, if we
if we apply the brake, particularly two-wheeler will slip by. So I was aware, I was fully conscious, but suddenly someone crossed the road and my auto reflexes worked at that moment, and I put the hand on my brake and my foot on my brake. And immediate, all in a fraction of second, the bike got slipped. And I was like, you know, oh my God, what happened? And then immediately I was so conscious, thanks to you and your learnings, teachings, basically, that I remembered God and I said to him that I accept this and I surrender. And I was dragged for at least 9 to 10 feet.
Oh my God.
Because it was sand and metal, so speed zyada ho gayi.
Okay.
Speed increased actually while falling as well. Yeah. So the bike was on the left side and I was on the right side of the road.
And I fell on the you fell off the bike.
Yeah.
You shot out of the bike. You were thrown out of the bike.
Yes. And jab main gira, when I just at the moment of falling, I had a fear, but on the very next moment, I surrendered. And I said, God, you take care. And I fall on my right hand side. And the fourth rib got a little fracture.
Oh my God.
And at the time of falling, the rib which pressed inside, pressed the lung also.
Okay.
So I wasn't able to breathe properly. But the very moment I was still on the road, I gathered all my senses and I woke up. So there were around 7-8 people who came for the rescue. They supported me, have me sit somewhere, and you know, basically what I want to share with you, that there was no fear at all. Fear was there for a second, probably for a fraction of a second. But then later I said to God that I accept and I surrender. Now you take care.
Very good. Lovely.
And then there was pain. And I said to myself that I am not body.
Okay.
I'm not body. Okay, it's all right. And then I went home. I took two hours sleep. Left hand side pe main soya. After 2 hours, when I karvat jab badli maine, when I turned, the pain started and it was terrible pain. And then we started from home and I got admitted into the hospital. So what I really want to share that I was completely, since that incident until today, I say to myself that I am not body, I am not mind, I am not ego, but I am catching myself every moment, whenever I am being my mind and ego. Or mere bade bhai ke saath mein ek conversation hua. I'm sorry, here I'll take one more minute.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, and I was telling him that if I died at that moment, if I had died at that moment, I'm sure that God, I don't claim to be enlightened person, but God must have really given me one chance. As a human being, jao aur apna enlightenment pao.
Okay, very good. You realize this, and thank you for sharing. It's very good for everybody to realize what I like is a couple of things. I really am very happy about that. One, in that moment, you said I surrendered. Fantastic. That is really very good. That shows you are conscious of the divine's presence. And two, when you said, body mein pain hai, but a person like you, who's on the journey of enlightenment. See, let's sort of understand one thing. Everybody on this call is on some level of enlightenment. I hope you agree. I'm not here to compare who is at what level, who is at 10%, who is 20%, who is 40%, who is 80%. I'm not trying to compare. We all are on that journey of enlightenment. We are all trying to realize the truth. We all have realized the truth up to some extent. Some have realized, like Kiran said, Kiran has honestly said, she's such an elderly, respectful person. And Kiran, kya bolti hai? Kiran, straight away, Kiran is saying, okay, I know, I realize everything, I understand. But kabhi kabhi, ego aa jata hai. Ego overtakes me. So now she is trying her best. She's there every day on the call. Kiran is every day on the call because she is very clear. I want Nirvana. I want moksha. There are some people who are on this, they are not on this call, but they say, hame Nirvan chahiye, hame moksha chahiye. Aitam tu kaam ki tum call pe aao. Nahi, main call pe nahi aata. Tere chodo. Tum kya baat karte hai? Tumhe call pe nahi aa sakta, tumhe Nirvan chahiye, moksha chahiye. Nirvan moksha kya koi mithai hai kya? कोई मिठाई की दुकान में जाके मेरा निर्वाण मोक्ष खरीद के लाएगा. सो राजेंद्र इज वेरी गुड. आई मीन आई एम हैप्पी दैट वी आर ऑल शेयरिंग आवर एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड वी हैव टू ग्रो एंड यू आर राइट. आई एम टेलिंग यू व्हाट यू सेड इज सो प्रोफाउंड. सपोज यू हैड डाइड, मतलब और एक जन्म ना राजन, दैट मींस और एक जन्म, अनदर 9 months इन द मदर्स वूम एंड अनदर जन्म. कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दैट मींस?
Yes, yes. And air, after that conversation, I was present to the fact ki Paramatma, when God has saved me, thoda sa extension, God has given me extension. So I must make the best use of it.
Good. He has given you a bell. Alarm has come on to remind you.
Yes.
Thank you, Rajendra. Thank you for sharing some. I believe Samita wants to say something. Yes, Samita.
Shivam, sir.
Shivam, Samita.
I want to share something with you. You said to share. Really, I think it's more than a year since I'm attending the calls. And I have changed a lot from within. I can feel it. I have stopped reacting. Because otherwise, I used to react and I used to feel bad. Now I know everything is a drama. So I don't react. And I was also available 24/7 to everyone, except to myself. Now I have set my priorities. And I have learned to give time to myself to what I want to do. Even coming on this call regularly was not easy, but now I have made it. And also, like when you said, even 2 minutes, 5 minutes silence is good. I started doing that, wherein now I can listen to my inner body speaking. I'm alert to that, to the messages that they give. And also like seeing God in everyone. I have not reached that level where I can see God in everyone. But I can see God in my plants. Previously, any nice rows of plant, I used to cut it and go put it in the vase. Now I admire it on the plant. I say, you look very nice here. Then my pets, I can see I can literally talk to them through the eyes, seeing God in them. And also when I lost my kitten, that I've already told you once, I learned detachment. I can also see God in my children, but still I have to climb up. Wherein I have not conquered my ego, as Kiran Aunty said, to see the God in my mother-in-law. I'm waiting for that day. So I can say, okay, I have really climbed up. And I'm sure that day will come soon if I keep attending your class.
Thank you for sharing, Samita. Thank you for your... see, this honest sharing is very, very important. It is not easy to make an honest sharing. But you know, what Samita just said, she was a slave to everybody else. What she said now, my 24/7, I was available to everybody else. So many of you, some men are there. They are the slave of the house. They are the ghoda of the house. The man has to do this. The man has to go supermarket. The man has to go to buy the vegetable market, mutton market. The man has to do everything. Then there are some women. Women to ghar ki naukarani ban gayi. Then you have the servant of the house. The woman has to do, she has to cook, she has to clean, she has to wash the toilet. She has to do everything. So what Samita is saying, no. I have set my priorities clear. For me, attending this call is important. If you'll notice, Samita, she's on this call every day. No, I don't care. I am on this call. Nobody can stop me. Even if somebody comes, you sit here. If somebody's on the call, I'm mute. Sometimes I switch off the video or something to manage. But that's the commitment for her enlightenment. My dear friends, if we become a handle and people are using us for everything else. And like Rajendra said, one day the opportunity is gone, the bell rings, ghanti baj jati hai, ding 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 ding, time to go. Then what you will do? Then will you say, Mr. Yama, please wait, I just want to go and come back? No, sorry, we will not wait. Many of you don't realize, many of you are slave of your duties. Many of you are slave of your responsibilities. But what about your biggest responsibility to your soul? What about the biggest responsibility for your life? This is what is lacking in enlightenment. This is what's lacking. People are mad. People are chasing money. People are chasing relationships. People are chasing so many things. But you don't have what Samita said. They're spending those moments in silence, trying to see God in the plants, and also admitting sometimes that I'm still not reached that level where there's a person in my life, I can't see God, that I have to overcome. Like Kiran said, sometimes the ego comes. But this call reminds us every day. My dear friends, what is the meaning of this call? It's very simple. I am the Atma. That's all. Neti, neti. Tattvam asi. Am I giving some complicated bhashan to y'all? Am I telling y'all very complicated shlokas of the Bhagavad Gita? Well, koi bhi, you go to Bhagavad Gita class, they'll give you bada bada shloka. Bada bada, hey Arjuna, ho gaya. Bada bada shloka. Kya hoga, bada bada shloka mein kya hoga? Please think about it. You just need simple. Neti, neti. Tattvam asi. Are, that much? You can't digest, then what is the use of her? Bada bada Ramayana ka aur ye Ved Puran, Shiva Puran, and yeah, what is the use? My dear friends, let us understand that we must realize, like Rajendra said, we don't know. Rajendra had an accident, he escaped. Who knows, tomorrow you and me will be on this call. There is no guarantee. We need to realize that time is now. We need to realize the fact that we are the divine soul. Tattvam asi. I am Atma Brahma, Prajnanam Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi. Shivoham, Shivoham. That's all. The entire learning is in our... I don't think anybody would have a learning which is 10 words or 10, maybe 10 lines. Huh? Last time Hitkari ji ke karan, who remembers Hitkari's 10 keys? I don't remember who remembers. Hitkari ji said, give me practical 10 keys. Anybody remembers the 10 keys of liberation we spoke about? Who knows it? Anybody has? Somebody must be having written down. Talash. Huh? Neti, neti, tattvamasi. I know them in different order. Satchidanand, Jivan Mukta, Yoga.
Uh-huh. Yes, Kiam I can Shivam read it.
Tell me, that's right. Please read.
Talash, Mumukshatva.
Mumukshatva.
Sravan Manan Nididhyasan.
Good.
Neti Neti.
Neti Neti.
Tattvamasi.
Tattvamasi.
Saddarshan.
Saddarshana.
Union with God.
Yes.
Satyam Shivam Sundaram.
Okay.
Satchit Anand.
Satchit Anand.
Jivan Mukta.
Jivan Mukta. We don't want to complicate. The journey to God is simple. God is inside. God is right inside. He is not far away. He is inside you. But you are searching in the whole world. So I think I enjoyed the call today. And we are reaching the end of this call. Anybody else wants to say something quickly? Otherwise, we have to close the call.
Yes, sir. I have a question.
Lakshmi wants to share something here, and we have Lakshmi, five quickly, questions.
Quickly share, Lakshmi.
About my thing, I usually share with you as my mother's thing. I just want to tell others also how I was thinking about my mother, how I lost, and after talking to you, how I have overcome that. I don't want to miss any of your sessions. Now I have started attending, and even on Mondays also, sir. So I don't want to miss any of your sessions here. Yeah. So whenever I read, Now I'll bring back my mind again. I'll think that I have to not, because one or other day, even we also have to go back. So I have come out of that thing, sir.
Good, Lakshmi. Nice to have you so back in the place.
Challenge.
So Lakshmi lost her mother, and she used to every day cry. And I lost my mother. But then the realization has to come. Finally, everybody has to go. Thank you, Lakshmi. Thank you for sharing. I think that we will not keep people for the beyond the time. And we will again meet tomorrow. Those who have questions, I request you to keep the questions and start with your questions. Don't wait. As the administrator starts reading typed questions, social media questions. Please start with your questions so that it gets a good impetus. There's a good takeoff of the Ask Air aeroplane and we all go forward. I bow down to all of you for spending this valuable time. I'm grateful to you for making this meaningful discussion with your questions, your answers, your patient listening. Each of you is a manifestation of God. That's why I start by saying Shivoham to all of you, because I see you as Shiva. I hope you see yourself as Shiva. I bow down to you. God bless. Shivoham.